is AMD latest Navy graphics card, the Radeon 5700 XT, good for content creators? How is the performance compared to the Vega Frontier Edition? Can you run it in your Hackintosh build? Let's find out! Hi, I'm Teresa from Morgonau.cloud and I help people with Hackintosh builds, Macintosh computers, Linux servers, simply with computers. If you are new here, then please click that subscribe button and hit the bell next to it so you won't miss any of my future videos. Right in the beginning, I have to say, if you are living in a hope you will buy the Radeon 5700 XT for your Hackintosh build and enjoy its performance for such a low price, you are out of luck, at least for now. After my initial tests, it is not compatible even with the latest beta of macOS 10.15 Catalina. But, as for example, Apple Insider wrote on their website, there are 8 references to GPUs bearing the RX and Pro prefixes in macOS Catalina beta, including 7 under Vega 20. Link to this article you can find in video description. So for sure we can't know at this point what exact cards that indicates, but I strongly believe support for the AMD Radeon 5700 XT cards will come to macOS Catalina soon. And because I cannot test this card under macOS, I prepared for you little preview of what this card is capable in my beloved Windows 10. So, for comparison or as a reference card, I chose amazing AMD GPU for content creators, the Vega Frontier Edition with 16 GB of VRAM, which I used in my main production machine for a long time until I replaced it with Radeon 7 last month. Both GPUs I tested in the same computer with Intel Core i9-9900K and 64 GB of HyperX memory at 3200 MHz CL16 timings. So, as you can see, I am really running the Vega Frontier Edition with 4096 shaders and AMD 19.7.2 driver. Let's start with the Luxmark benchmark. points. Now let's move on to Geekbench OpenCL benchmark. points. And as a real-life test I chose render test of my last video project. I am using at the date of shooting the latest DaVinci Resolve Beta 6 version. My timeline is at 4K resolution, 30 fps. My source media are ProRes 422LT, 4K resolution, 30 fps, and it's 10-bit footage. As well, I have some H.264 screen recordings. Timeline resolution in 4K, no automatic pre-caching of content, no render cache, I will delete any leftovers, no optimized media. So work from direct source media. Timeline scrubbing is not so smooth as on my macOS Mojave system. So let's render it out and set the reference render time to be. So, the Vega Frontier Edition rendered my quite 6 minutes long project in 9 minutes 33 seconds. So, let's finally move to the AMD Radeon 5700 XT. Radeon 5700 XT, Navy 10 architecture, 2560 shaders, 8 GB of VRAM, And most important information here is the AMD driver version. Same as for the Vega Frontier test, so 19.7.2. I will show you it's really at the date of shooting of this video, really the latest driver available. I will tell you why this is important later in this video. So let's start again with the Luxmark benchmark. $29,985. So the Radeon 5700 XT is 4.2% faster than the Vega Frontier edition in this test. So let's move on to Geekbench OpenCL test. $316,379, absolutely overkill. I'll talk about it later. And as before, let's redo the same render test in DaVinci Resolve. Time to beat is 9 minutes 33 seconds. So, the Radeon 5700 XT rendered this project in 10 minutes 9 seconds. That's 6.3% slower than the Vega Frontier edition. But you maybe didn't notice one very important thing. Look at my Source Progress media previews. They are crippled. Media itself plays fine, but previews are distorted. Same but opposite problem is with the H.264 footage. Previews are fine, but the media plays with huge artifacts. When I check the final rendered file, everything is absolutely fine, no artifacts present, but simply only in timeline it's terrible. This is a definitely driver issue. I get the same problem when testing the 5700 XT under Linux. On the media page it's even more prominent. So that's why I showed you a few minutes ago, I am really running it on the latest available AMD driver. So let's hope AMD will fix this issue soon. So let's summarize it. Vega Frontier Edition has 4096 shader units versus only 2560 on the 5700 XT. In other words, the 5700 XT has only quite half the shaders than the Vega FE. Vega FE has super fast HBM memory versus the GDDR6 on the 5700 XT. But still, 5700 XT can beat the Vega FE in OpenCL benchmarks, while it's just 6.3% slower in video rendering in DaVinci Resolve. Maybe it's also due to some kind of problem in those AMD drivers. Another interesting finding is the 5700 XT core clock was most of the time at 2100 MHz while the rendering. As you may know, I never overclock CPUs nor GPUs, I always show the stock performance you can get. As you saw, the 5700 XT totally crushed the Vega Frontier edition quite as double the score in Geekbench OpenCL benchmark. 316,379 points versus just 180,965 points. That means 5700 XT is 74.8% faster in this test. When we compare it to other GPUs, the Radeon 5700 XT is far above the Nvidia RTX 2080 and very close to Tesla V100 and Titan RTX. So 5700 XT belongs to the elite club of most powerful GPUs. Overall, the AMD Radeon 5700 XT is by my opinion very capable GPU, which can handle 3D OpenCL rendering or 4K video editing without any problem. It can handle even 8K 60fps footage, as I tested. Hackintosh users must wait a little bit until the support will hopefully come to the macOS 10.15 Catalina. So if you want new Hackintosh build right now and you don't want to wait, you should stick with Vega GPU. or even better, the Radeon 7, which is far the best currently supported GPU for the macOS and Hackintosh. By the way, I made whole dedicated video just to Radeon 7 on Hackintosh, so watch it if you are interested about its performance. But as I said, I strongly believe in close future the support for 5700 XT will come to macOS Catalina. By the way, yes, you can see well, I have some more surprises for you in my next video, so stay tuned. So, I hope I gave you again some new inspiration. If so, please click on the like button below. Click also the share button so more people can benefit from it. Subscribe to my channel and hit the bell next to it so you won't miss any of my future videos. And if you would need some help with your computer, you can always get my personal support on my Patreon or Subscribestar. Links are again in this video description. You can also reach me at my Facebook, Twitter, Reddit or my website. Morgonaut is always here to help. So, that's all for today. Thank you for watching and see you next time, my Hackintosh friends.